Hi and welcome. This is a 15-minute Inferno Hot Pilates class titled Awesome Arms. My name is Latoya and this is Liz. We are going to be showing you how to sculpt awesome arms with an amazing sequence that's only 15 minutes. You've got 15 minutes. You've got time to sculpt. Are you ready? Score. Liz, are you ready? Let's do this, gang. Go ahead and lie down on your back. You want to start by just relaxing and getting yourself grounded. Send your legs long, relax your arms by your side, close your eyes. Take a deep inhale breath through your nose. Exhale sharply through your teeth. Good, two more just like that. Inhale. Yes, exhale. By pushing the air out of your teeth, tightness through your stomach, inhale. Exhale, really squeeze your abdominal muscles. Awesome. Open up your eyes, bend your knees, beginning to warm up your glutes because they're amazing and they deserve it as well. Bring your arms down by the side, palms flat on the floor. Feet hip-width distance apart, heels behind the toes. Press your feet down, ground into your arms as you take a deep breath in. Exhale, tuck, curl, and lift your hips up. Push the floor away to get your hips as high as you can and hold it there. Take a deep breath. As slow as you can, exhale, come down to a hover. Slow and strong. Two more. Inhale through your nose. Exhale, tuck, curl, and lift. Squeeze your butt muscles. Draw your knees in just a bit. Breathe in. Exhale, come down to that hover. Never letting your glutes relax. Last one. Deep breath in. Exhale, tuck, curl, lift. Just like that. Drive through your heels, breathe at the top. Exhale, slowly come down one vertebra at a time. And it is time to go. DJ, drop that funky beat. Oh, here it is. You are going to be going into hip width bridges in 3, 2, 1, start. It's up, down, up, down. So good. Your breath is with your movement every single time. Exhale at the top. Inhale as you hover. You lift, hover. Lift, hover. Just like that. Starting to fire into your glutes. Yes. Your glute muscles are involved in every single thing that you do. Whether you sit or you stand or you walk, doesn't matter. Power muscles are going. Good. Lift up, hover. Up, hover. Nice job. In just a moment, you're going to take this into calf raises by coming up as high as you can on your toes and keeping your hips at the highest level. It's coming. 3, 2, right here. Freeze. Now come up on your toes. As you scoot your feet in a couple of inches, lift your hips up one more. That's your highest height. Hold it there. Moving your heels in 3, 2, 1, go. It's down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Just like that. The goal is that your hips do not drop at all. They barely move. How do you do that? As your heels touch the ground, you squeeze your butt really tight to keep your hips up. Press into your palms. Use your arms to also help keep your hips lifted. Yes, it's up and down, up and down. Building strength in your ankles, improving strength in your calves. So good. Going into some hip pulses to finish up this round of bridges. It's coming. Down. 3, 2, freeze. You hold it right there and tiny squeezes. Set. Go. It's up. 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 Very little movement here. Big difference from when you were lifting and hovering, full range of motion. And this one, if you can see Liz, they're barely moving. You've got to like get a magnifying glass to see. she's making tight squeezes in her glute muscles, and the hips just keep lifting. Stay high on your toes here. So working into your calves. Pull the knees in just a bit, and we're gonna count it down from 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly come down. You can bring your knees into your chest and shake out your legs. Bridges are done. For your Tabata work today, you're gonna work 9 straight minutes with little bits of breaks. You have 9 rounds of arm movements, 50 seconds of work, 10 seconds of rest. I've got my trusty Tabata timer. I've got my amazing model. I've got you at home. Let's get to it. First movement, cobra push-up. Flip over onto your stomach. Place your hands underneath your shoulders, palms flat. Feet, tops of the feet on the floor, legs straight. You're gonna lift and lower yourself starting now. You go. Just get into this movement and I'll guide you through. First thing to remember is all about breathing. If you can breathe, you're doing 100% correct. Keep your palms flat on the floor. Use your hands to push yourself up right above your belly button. Yeah. Pull your elbows in so you are working your tricep muscles. Ooh, sun's out, guns out, yo. Feet can be apart or they can be together if you want to level this up a little bit. You've got about 15 seconds left. Stay with that pace. Breathe out at the top. Inhale as you lower down. Yeah, Liz, take it to the top. Rest is coming in just a moment. Change. You've got mountain climbers coming up. Push yourself into a high plank position. Step your right leg back, left leg back. Bringing your right knee to right elbow, left knee to left elbow. Go. Time has started. Here you work your arms by pushing the floor away from you. A slight round through the upper back. Spread your fingers and equally distribute your body weight over your hands palms. You literally want to bring your knee to touch your elbow. So as you work your arms, you're also working your calves. Double A! Get it, Liz! Working it at home! 15 seconds left in this round! You get it. Exhale through your teeth. As sharp as you can. So good. You're rocking it. Change. Nice. Liz is going to come down and sit on her tuchus for tricep dips. Bring your legs out in front of you. Place your hands, palms behind you, fingers forward. Lift your hips up, lift your toes up, and go. Little dips. Nice. Breathe in and breathe out. Again, here you're working your tricep muscles. Elbows bend directly behind you versus winging out to the side. If you're unable to bring your butt to the ground as you dip, mini bends in your elbows can produce maximum results in your body. 15 seconds to go. You got this. Coming up after this round, you're in push-ups. Yeah, keep it going. Get a couple more in. Nice work. Change. Bring your legs behind you again. Lie down on your belly, hands underneath your shoulders. Tuck your toes under and push yourself up to a high plank position. And slowly lower down to your chest. Then push yourself all the way back up. Repeat. At your pace. This is where you become the master of your fitness fate. You decide how fast you go. You decide what level you're at. And it's always going to be enough as long as you're trying your absolute best. If this is like, híjole, go back to your cobra push-ups. You can also bend your knees just like that. Perfect. You've got 15 seconds here. Doing absolutely amazing. You go all the way through because you know you get 10 seconds to rest after this round. Yes, you do. Get it, girl. Get it, guys. Work it. Change. Just lie down here. You're going to go into a plank, moving into a side plank right, back to plank, side plank left. So you just stay here. Set yourself up now, high plank position. Feet about hip width distance and go. You're in it. You're going to move through your sides, right and left at your pace. You want to pause for at least a second to hold your side plank and to hold your full plank. Notice that smile. It's okay to have fun, even if you're suffering a little bit. Yeah. Liz is keeping her feet hip width distance, so as she rotates into her side plank, the hips stay stacked as possible. About 10 seconds left here, everybody. Then you're going to lie down onto your right side. Get it. Woo! Look at that. Change. Lie down on the right side for a sideline push-up. Cross your right hand over your chest to touch your left shoulder. Bring your left palm flat in front of you. Set it up and go. You've got 25 seconds here working the left arm. And when I say switch, you're going to flip your legs and you're going to the right. She's staggering her legs just a bit, slight bend in the knees. Good. You are pressing the full palm. That's it. Coming up. 3, 2, switch! Sweep your legs around. Cross your left arm to your right shoulder and go! You're in it. No time to waste. That was good moving. Nice work here. Excellent. Push yourself all the way up. Get your arms locked out and then lower down. Change. Excellent form. You can stay there and just roll onto your belly. Push yourself up to high plank position. You're going into a push-up. When you press yourself back up, you're going to tap your right toes, tap your left toes, back into a push-up. Go. Oh, I love it. There you go. Notice when Liz lowers down. She's controlling the descent by keeping her body in a plank position, squeezing tight through the midsection. Booty strong, thighs contracted. Elbows hugging very close to the body, building strength in the arms. The toe taps slow and controlled. But if you want to level this up and you tap out both feet at the same time, listen, do it. I'm all for it. Keep going. You got this. You've got a rest coming up in just a moment. Change. Lie down on your belly. Coming up next is a lateral plank walk. You're going to come up into a high plank form, and you're going to walk yourself out to the right, out to the left. 2 times. 3, 2, 1. Go. Right, right. Left, left. Excellent. As you move your left hand, your left foot steps out. And as you move your right hand, your right foot steps out. Keep the hips down just a little bit. Pull in tight, ribs to hips, belly in strong. Very good. Keep your eyes one spot in front of you. Working to make the neck nice and long. Rocking it out. Keep breathing in. Breathing out, your breath is key here. If you need to do this on your knees, you can. Keep your shoulders stacked above your wrists. Ribs to hips, stomach in, couple seconds. Change, just like that, it's done. Setting up for the final movement, forearm plank into a dolphin. Place your forearms on the floor so your palms will be flat so you can go into your dolphin, right leg back, left leg back. Hold this plank for just a second here. Shift your weight forward, heels over the toes. Good. Now take a deep breath. As you exhale, shoot your hips up as high as you can. Head through your arms. Good. And lower back into your forearm plank. Repeat at your pace. Nice. As you come forward, squeeze in tight. As you lift the hips, spine long. Very nice. Body weight stays forward. Heels over the toes in your forearm plank. Look at that control. Keep it going. Less than 10 seconds, and you get a little bit of a cool down stretch to seal your workout today. You got this. 5, 4, 3, 2, change. Come down. Set yourself up on all fours right away. Just a little bit of a shoulder stretch. Thread the needle. Bring your left arm up and reach it through your right arm and your right leg. Come down to your left side of the head. Look towards your hand. Good. Right arm can go long. If you want a little extra stretch through your chest, you can wrap your right arm behind your lower back for a little bite. Breathe in through your nose. Breathe out through your mouth. Excellent job. Bring your right hand to the floor. Push yourself back into that all fours position. Right arm up. Sweep it through. Thread your needle. If your head doesn't come all the way down to the ground, that's okay. You do the best you can. Left arm goes long, or you reach it behind you. Breathe in. Breathe out. Way to show up for yourself today. 15 minutes can do so much for your body and your mind. Push yourself up back into that floor. Yep. Take a deep breath in. As you exhale, bring your big toes together, open your knees, and rest in child's pose here. Arms go long, and you just stay here as long as you like. Thank you so much for joining us today. We hope to see you soon. Have an amazing rest of your day. Bye.